The now 23-year-old Irishman's musical career began in 2010 when he auditioned for X Factor UK.
Because you walked out the door.
You're not as good as you thought you were, but I still like you.
Although eliminated as a solo contestant, Niall was teamed up with four other talented misfits who went on to become a group called One Direction. You may have heard of them. They sold a bunch of albums, made the Guinness Book of World Records and stuff. Right now, the 1D dudes are having a hiatus. It's basically a nice way of saying they still like each other, but want to sleep with, record with other people. Last year, Horan signed a recording deal as a solo artist with Capitol Records and began to unleash his swaggering style on the captivated world.
Yesterday, I thought I saw your shadow running around.
Now he's come to the Down Underverse to tell you all about his second solo single. Slow Hands is another platinum hit and it's been performed everywhere, from US Late Night to Ariana Grande's One Love Manchester tribute.
Yeah, I want you, baby.
We want you too, Niall. Now let's get a look at your beautiful face.
Could you please welcome Niall Horan and his face?
How you doing, guys?
Oh, doing very well. So Capitol Records, hey? This is big. What's it like being signed on the same label that's been home to Frank Sinatra, Nat King Cole, these sorts of people?
That's been my favourite part, actually, having access to people who run that show and having access to the studios in there and seeing all the sick pictures on the wall of Sinatra recording in there. And I actually got to use Frank's mic a couple of times before, so it was... That's been the best part.
But was there any fallout from it? I mean, was Simon Cowell secretly furious that you didn't sign on with his label?
No. We were fairly mutual on it. We knew that we had had a lot of success together, and I just felt like it was a good time for a little bit of a change. We sold many records together, so there's no hard feelings.
Is there a huge sense of freedom post One Direction? Surely it must feel nice to have more creative control now.
Yeah, I think that's been probably the best part. Like, time has been on my side. I've just spent the last year and a half in and out of the studio and picking my producer, you know, getting a band to play live on the album. It's kind of given me the freedom to just go and do exactly what I want.
Niall, I wanted to ask you about the 1D boys. Firstly, there must be, like, different strengths for different things. Like, who's the best to go out on a big night with?
Louis.
who's the best to say watch the Notebook with?
Oh, probably Harry, yeah.
Okay, and what about Harry, if you need to bury a dead body?
I won't be burying any of them, so... you, maybe?
Good answer. Hey, well.
You know what? To be honest, if you ask me, I'd do it for you.
Yeah. Katy Perry is going to be on our show tomorrow night. She's been a bit cheeky. She's been going around claiming you are always trying to pick her up. We have a little clip of her here. Have a listen.
Niall's amazing. I love him. I see him around all the time. He's always trying to, like, get my number to, like, maybe flirt with you, but I'm like,
desperate.
I can babysit you. I'm like your mom.
Have you got any message for Katy that we can relay to her tomorrow?
Katy, please stop being mean to me. She's just finding any excuse now to just patronise me and go around spreading rumours about me. I just want to be your friend.
Because wasn't she part of the reason why you are where you are today?
Yeah, on my first audition, when I auditioned myself, she actually had the deciding vote to put me through. And she's one of my favourite people that I know. I wish everyone could be friends with Katy Perry. She's hilarious. And you'll see that yourself when you
meet her. Yeah, we wish that too. Yeah. And, also, and you.
And also, I get it, Niall, because, I mean, I had the hots for my teacher sometimes in school as well. So, you know, they help you and you get it. You know?
I mean, she's talking like she's about 55 years older than me. You know what I mean? She's not that much older than me.
Being part of One Direction, it must have been an incredible experience. And history kind of says that when you're in a band like that, that's just the biggest thing on the planet, one of those boy bands especially, it's a fairly short window where you become like the biggest stars on the planet. But when you're in the middle of it, does that go through your mind? Do you see it that way?
No, I wouldn't say so. At the start, we were 16, 17, 18 years old. And it feels like you're at school. But we just have a mad job. I always used to wonder what it looked like from the outside.
Well, just before we let you go, when are we going to get to hear the full album?
Yeah, I'm hoping. I'm doing a lot of promo, as you can see, at the minute. So I'm kind of all over the place. And then when I get back, I'll look to bring out the album probably October, November time, somewhere. Hopefully October, I'm thinking. And then at the minute, we're trying to stick a tour together, and then I shall probably make my way back down to Australia, because I'll kill whoever doesn't bring me down here.
All right. Well, hopefully we can have you on the desk next
yes,
time.
Yes, make sure you swing by when you do that. In the meantime, would you please thank Niall?
Thank you.